What's happening, ladies and germs? This is the Packer Man, and welcome to a new Let's Play, Super Mario World. The first Super Nintendo game I played when it first came out, because obviously, it was the Pac-Man title. Definitely one of my favorite entries in the Mario franchise. And we're going to be starting that here today. I'm going to let you know right up front that this Let's Play is going to be 9 episodes long, because we're going to be doing all 9 worlds, obviously. And each episode will feature one of those worlds. So, without further ado, as you can see, I've already played a little bit. Let's go ahead and erase that. And we're going to try to get all 96 exits in this game. There are 72 total levels with 24 secret exits. Let's do it. Welcome. This is Dinosaur Land. In this strange land, we find that Princess Toadstool is missing again. Looks like Bowser is at it again. Still not known as Peach yet. Welcome. We start out at Yoshi's Island. There are 2 paths that we can take. Let's go inside Yoshi's house real quick. This is a good opportunity to test out your controls. Like for me, Y is run and grab. B is regular jump, and A is the spin jump. And information block. Hello, sorry I'm not home, but I have gone to rescue my friends who were captured by Bowser, Yoshi. What do you say we go help him out, huh? Obviously, we want to go to the left path first, because there's something important this way. Here we go. And those are dragon coins, by the way. Collect 5 of them for a 1-up. Obviously, up there is a item box. Damn it. It's been a while since I've played Super Mario World. And that's what happens when you use the spin stomp. You can also use it to break blocks. Woo! And there's also the halfway tape, basically a checkpoint. Point of advice, you can hold an extra item in the box at the top of the screen. To use it, press the select button. I forget which button it is. It's probably the minus button on here. To point up and to pick up a shell, use the X or Y button. To throw a shell upwards, look up and let go of the button. Now notice those, let me pause the game real quick. Notice those kind of dotted line squares on the screen right there. For those of you that don't know, those are blocks that will activate once you find the Switch Palace. There's 4 different color Switch Palaces, by the way. The first one we're going to encounter is yellow. The yellow and green ones contain power-ups. The blue and pink ones, I think it's blue. It's either blue and pink or blue and red. Those ones just provide platforms, basically, to get to previously unreachable areas. But the yellow blocks contain mushrooms, no matter what, and the green ones contain cape feathers, no matter what. All right. Fire flower. Now in this game, fire flowers turn enemies into coins. There's a chuck, and there's the gold tape. And if you hit the tape, you get stars. Collect 100 stars to get to a bonus game. We basically play a Mario-ized version of tic-tac-toe. Alright, now we go up, and there's the yellow switch palace. Coins! Coins for days! Switch Palace, hit. And also this game has a save feature too, so that's cool. Of course, since I'm playing it on the Switch, that won't be necessary. Now, thing about the map. Notice the yellow dots. Those are just, you know, stages with just one exit. Typically, the ones with two exits are red dots. That's how you know that there's more than one exit. However, some of the different levels, like the ghost houses, some of them have multiple exits too. And I'll point those out when we get to them. Okay, Yoshi's Island 2. There's Yoshi! Hooray! Thank you for rescuing me. My name is Yoshi. On my way to rescue my friends, Bowser trapped me in that egg. So this is basically the first meeting between Mario and Yoshi. To do a spin jump, press the A button. A Super Mario spin jump can break some of the blocks and defeat some of the tougher enemies. And you can also jump off of Yoshi too, if you need to. And also when Yoshi grabs certain shells, they can perform different types of attacks. Point of advice, this gate marks the middle of this area. By cutting the tape here, you can continue from close to this point. That's if you lose a life at some point. And if you already have a Yoshi, when you find another egg, it hatches into a 1-up. Yoshi can swallow most enemies too. Care of that. Yeah! 40 stars. Yeah, this first world is pretty straightforward. Yoshi's Island 3. Oh yeah, this one. The big coins are dragon coins. If you pick up 5 of these in one area, you get an extra Mario. And some levels, in some cases, have more than 5. Maybe if you've already collected if you've already collected 5 dragon coins, if you collect the 6th, it's an automatic 1-up. Yoshi swallowing a red Koopa. We'll allow him to shoot fire. When you stomp on an enemy, you can jump high if you hold the jump button. Use up on the control pad and jump to jump high in the shallow water. I don't remember what the requirement for that is, but that star block is kind of random, whether you get a coin or a 1-up. And we're going to Yoshi's Island 4 next. This is the last regular level of Yoshi's Island, first world. It's Pokey! If you are in an area that you have already cleared, you can return to the map screen by pressing Start then Select. Oh, and anything Yoshi eats counts as a coin. The Starman is back. And of course, we have no more enemies to hit. You get bonus stars if you cut the tape at the end of each area. If you collect 100 bonus stars, you can play a fun bonus game, which is what we're going to be doing right now. So basically, you see how the squares are basically like a roulette. What you want to try to do is time it so that you hit mushrooms. And there's a trick to it where if you time it just right, you can hit all mushrooms. Obviously, I got a bunch of flowers. And you get 1-ups. Alright. Last level of World 1. Iggy's Castle. And Yoshi can't come inside for this. Open sesame. Press up on the control pad while jumping, and you can cling to the fence to go in the door at the end of the area. Use up also. And you can also hit the fence too. And of course, the jumping on enemy for 1-ups mechanic is still in effect for this game. Seriously? Whatever. and you can also use the punch feature to knock out enemies on the other side. And this right here, you punch this, and it switches you to the other side. So you can get a lot of one-ups right here. A point of advice. One of Yoshi's friends is trapped in the castle by Iggy Koopa. To defeat him, push him into the lava pool. Okay, now we got an auto-scroll level. Or an auto-scroll portion. Gotta watch out for the, Crusher. Here we go. Got him. And if you have a fire flower, you can use your fireballs to push him in too. And that's it. And after you defeat each castle, there's a cool little cutscene that happens. Mario has defeated the demented Iggy Koopa in Castle Number 1 and rescued Yoshi's friend who is still trapped in an egg. Together, they now travel to Donut Land. And that is the next world. Which gives us a save point. And that's where we're going to cut it off here for this first episode. Next time we start world number 2, Donut Land, or as it says right here, the Donut Plains. So, and we're going to have our first encounter with a level that has more than one exit. So, thank you very much for watching, and until next time, this is the Packer Man, signing out. See you later.
You better like and subscribe, or face the consequences. You have been warned.